In this video, we're going to discuss the solution to question 15 from the practice final exam for Math 1220. And in this question, we're asked to compute, well, to find the Taylor series for the function f of x equals the natural log of x centered at a equals 1. So one thing to remember when it comes to Taylor series is that the formula for the Taylor series will be the sum where n ranges from 0 to infinity. You're going to get the nth derivative of the function evaluated at the center a divided by n factorial, and you're going to times that by x minus a to the n. So we need to start calculating derivatives of this function. So if we take the zeroth derivative, that's just the function itself, which is the natural log of x. We divide that by, well, not divide, we take the first derivative, we're going to get 1 over x. We're going to take the second derivative, and so by the power rule, or if you're really into it right now, you could do the quotient rule. But by the power rule, because you're thinking of this as x to the negative 1 right here, you're going to get negative 1 over x squared. The next derivative, we have to calculate enough so that we can identify the pattern here. The next derivative, if you want, this would be negative x to the negative 2. You're going to get positive 2x to the negative 3, or I'll write this as 2 over x cubed. And this would equal the same thing as 2x to the negative 3. And you're going to see this pattern continues on as you take the fourth derivative. You're going to get 2 times 3, which is, that's a 4 right there if you can't tell. 4. So the next one we're going to get 1 times 2 times 3 over x to the 4th. And then it's going to be negative in this situation. If we do the fifth derivative, you're going to end up with a positive 1 times 2 times 3 times 4 over x to the 5th. And so in general terms, notice what's happening here. You're going to get for the nth derivative of x, it seems to be alternating. It goes positive, negative, positive, negative, positive. So it's offset by 1. So when you have an odd derivative, it's going to be a positive number. So that's going to be a negative 1 to the n plus 1, or minus 1 if you prefer. Something like that would work. And then in the numerator, you seem to have a factorial going on there. 1, 2, 3, 4. It's always 1 less than where we started. So the power on the bottom is going to be x to the first derivative had a first power, second derivative had a second power, third derivative had a third power. So you're going to get x to the end of the denominator, and then you have an n minus 1 factorial in the top. This gives us the general formula for the derivative, so long as n is greater or equal to 1, because the zeroth derivative is just the natural log of this. And so for the Taylor series, we need to just, for the Taylor series of the natural log of x, we're going to get that this is equal to the first term, which is the natural log of 1. And then we're going to add to that the sum, starting at n equals 1. We're going to separate the 0 term from the rest because the 0 term doesn't quite match our pattern. But after we get to the first derivative, it does seem to match a very nice pattern. We're going to end up with, if we plug in these formulas, right, the nth derivative at 1 divided by n factorial times x minus 1 to the n as we go off towards infinity. Now, some things to mention here is that the natural log of 1 is 0, so that's just going to disappear. If we evaluate this function, the nth derivative at 1, you're going to end up with negative 1 to the n plus 1. You're going to get this n minus 1 factorial, but then you're going to get this 1 to the n. 1 to the n is just, of course, a 1. And so making some of these simplifications here, our Taylor series is going to look like the sum where n equals 1 to infinity. We're going to get a negative 1 to the n plus 1. We're going to get this n minus 1 factorial on top. We have this n factorial on the bottom, x minus 1 here to the n. And then finally, the n factorials do cancel a little bit because n can factor as n times n minus 1 factorial, for which those cancel. And so in the end, we get that the natural logs, Taylor series expansion at 1 is the sum where n equals 1 to infinity. We get this alternating sum, so we're going to get negative 1 to the n plus 1 over n times x minus 1 to the nth. And so this provides a way where we can compute the Taylor series expansion for this natural log function at 1. It doesn't have a Maclaurin series because we can't expand the natural log of 0 because it's undefined at 0. We have a vertical asymptote at 0, but we could expand it at 1. And this works out here. This question is not asking you actually to find the radius of convergence for this thing. If you're sitting at 1, the best you would expect would be the radius of convergence to be 1 itself, because expanding to the left as far as you go would be at 0, right? You can't get past 0. And you actually can show that the radius of convergence here is 1. You don't have to provide the interval convergence or the radius convergence on this one. You also don't have to prove that the function's equal to its Taylor series or its Maclaurin series. That is a fact that you could use here, but that's not what this question's asking. It's just asking to compute the Taylor series of a function. And this is by using the original formula we see right here. And this one that you'll see on the final, it'll be a function which has a predictable derivative pattern of some kind. Like the natural log is a good example. Some other good ones to consider would be like sinh or cosh, the hyperbolic functions, because the derivative of sinh is cosh and the derivative of cosh is sinh. So computing the Maclaurin series of sinh or cosh, for example, would be very, very similar to how we did that for sine and cosine. So those ones would be some other practice ones to try out on this one if you want to see some other examples.